So today I was going to share with you some raised beds that we made last year out of these IBC totes. We cut the top off and a little bit of the side as we're getting ready for spring. We're fixing to start amending these. We had some limited success with them last year. We had some sweet potatoes done really well in them. We didn't get them made till late in the year. So a lot of stuff was a little too late to try to plant. My original idea was to do strawberries in these, but we didn't have any luck with strawberries. I've tried strawberries twice now. Could never get it to get them to grow. Yeah, you see some leftover carrots there that we had in them. We're fixing to start getting these ready to amend with our compost and kind of turn them over and work the soil up a little bit and get all this green weeds and stuff out of them. The first thing that we done when we made these though was we cut the top out, and then I put about 12 inches of sawdust, just mixed wood sawdust that we got from a local pallet mill, and then we put some compost and mixed that with some native soil, and that's how we got all of these weeds that we're having to deal with now. I really wish we would have done that a little different. But the main reason I went with these IBC totes for raised bed was so that we could move them. I've got a skid steer that we use here on the farm some, and I can take my pallet forks and move them around. So like, we've been having a lot of frost, so if I would have already had these planted, I could have put them in a greenhouse or maybe even in my shop if I needed to for a day or two. Or in the summertime, I can move them, get them under the shade of these trees like we are here now, where maybe they miss that midday sun. But we're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna take my potato fork, or that's what I call it, and kind of turn these over and get them ready for some compost, kind of rake these weeds out. So me and my little helper, we've got a couple of these done and ready for compost. So what we're using for compost is some stuff that we made here on the farm. Again, like we talked about, I can get some sawdust from a local sawmill up the road. And so they bring it to us by the semi-load and we let it compost. But we made some faster compost by mixing that with chicken litter that come from a local farmer. And so we mixed one part chicken litter to two parts sawdust with our front end loader and piled it up, and that's been sitting rotten for about a year. So now that we've got that, we're gonna amend what we've got done here with the compost so we can show y'all what they look like. And I'm hoping to plant potatoes in two or three of these. I don't know, I've never done Irish potatoes or regular potatoes in these. Like I say, our sweet potatoes done really well in these last year. Anyway, we're gonna try it and see what happens. We're always experimenting with stuff, so see how it works. So I got a little more in this one than the other one, so I'm gonna shovel a little bit across.
I got some, Daddy.
All right. I'm really not sure yet if I'm gonna turn that in or leave it on top. And so for now, we're just gonna leave it on top. This is, like I say, chicken litter and sawdust. Chicken litter and sawdust that we get from people around local, and some of it comes from here off the farm. hey, we appreciate you guys watching. And don't forget to subscribe, ring that notification bell, and hit that like button if you like our videos. We'd really appreciate it. Isabella, you want to tell them, say, see you on the next video.
See you on the next video.
Come here.